महाकाय सूर्यकोटि सम्रभ निर्विघ्न कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाविव संवृत्तौ वागर्थ प्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ येनाक्षरसमाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृष्णं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम् धातुर्ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृसुबन्धादिर्धातुर्ब्रह्मात्मने नमः शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमाध्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीं भवेदां जाड्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्देतां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदाम् दत्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां गुण्यां करोम्यहं पाणिनीय प्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदी। ओके, कंटिन्यूइंग विथ लघु क्रिकेट अदेंग गुणः। सो अदेंग गुण इज अ सूत्र इंट्रोड्यूस्ड by Laghukara as he needs to talk about Gunasandhi. So before Gunasandhi he needs to introduce what is Guna Sanya. So this is Sanya Sutram Adeng Gunaha. Padachet is At Eng Gunaha. Let me highlight this. So Adeng Gunaha At Eng Gunaha. And at, what is at? At is just akara. If he had said a, then a would include all the 18 varieties of a, and all the swara ityadi bhedas. But the matra is restricted by this ta, which is called as taparakarana, to only akara. So akara, ekara, and okara, a-o, a-ong. So akara, ekara, and okara are called as guna. Then the takara after akara, that at in the sutra adeng gunaha, how is it getting the meaning of only akara? That is explained by the next sutra, which is also sanya sutra, taparas tatkalasya. There is an anuvritti of savarnasya. So taparaha tatkalasya savarnasya, taparaha तत्कालस्य सवर्णस्य संज्ञा स्यात्। सो दी त पर अक्षर यानी अकार। नाउ हियर इन अत, इन एग्जांपल अत अकार इज फॉलोड बाय त, तकार। देयरफॉर दी अत इज व्हाट, तह परह यस्मात् सह तपरह। सो अत इज तपरह वेयर तकार इज आफ्टर अकार। सो दैट स्टैंड्स फॉर the matra, the letters which have a similar matra as akara. So savarnasya, savarna means tatkalasya is that matra, of that matra, and savarna is any savarna with having that matra will be included. So a and its savarna, if there is any savarna to, so here it is only akara. Akara, at stands for only akara. Similarly, at stands for only akara, not akara. It stands for ikara, eth for ekara, aith for aikara, and oth for okara. Then there is another samasa possible, which is tatparaha taparaha. So tatparaha, after takara also what is there, that will also be called as taparaha. So in the next sutra also we will see, not next sutra but Vriddhi Lakshana, but here also if you see in the earlier sutra Adeng Gunaha. So At restricts the Sanya of Guna to only Akara, whereas the Eng also being preceded by Takara, this Eng is also Taparaha because Tat Paraha, Takara Paraha, this Ekara Eng. So this takara and ekara also make this takara and ekara as taparaha, and by tatparaha thereby A is also restricted only to Akara. And similarly Okara. So if you look at this Aang in the Sutra, Adengunaha, there this Aang is also Taparaha, and therefore Akara is the meaning of Aang in the Sutra. A stands only for Akara and O for Okara, and Akara by At. So the Sanya is only for Akara, Akara and Okara. That is the idea there. I'll skip the Vritti so we can go a little faster. We know the meaning. Then next sutra, where the Guna Sandhi is covered in the Sanyas, in the Sandhi section. So we are looking at the Sandhi Sutras here. Vidhi Sutram for the Ach Sandhi is Ad Gunaha. And the Anuvritti is Ekaha Puro Parayo Achi Samhitayam. So when an Ach vowel follows Avarna, then that Avarna and the following Ach both are replaced by a single Gunadesha. Puro Parayo Ekaha Adesha. For the earlier Avarna and the following Ach, there is a single Ekaha Adesha, which is Gunaha. Guna is what? Akara, Ekara or Okara. So one of these three is the Adesha for both the preceding and the following Samhitayam Vishe. So Samhitayam means when there is a Sandhi between the two without anything intervening. So the situation, you have an Avarna and then you have an Ach. The Adesha is Guna for both Avarna and Ach. So example is what? Before the example, in fact, there is an Apavada also covered here. So the Guna is a general sutra. There is a Guna. So what is the Guna ordained for? Guna is ordained for Purva Parayoho Ekaha Guna Adesha. So what is Purva? The Avarna. So Avarna means Akara and Akara. So that is Purva. And what is Para? Ach. So this entire thing is Ach from here to here. This entire thing is Ach. So that includes A, A, E, E, U, U, R, R, L, A, O, I and AU. Now this Guna is a general Utsarga, general Adesha for all of these following Akara, Akara. But there is an Apavada. So that Apavada is going to come up as to Savarna Dirga Sandhi. So whenever Akara, Akara is followed by Akara, Akara, then there is a Dirgha. So that Dirgha is an Apavada to Guna. Similarly, when Ikara, Ikara is preceded by Ikara, Ikara, but since in this sutra Guna, A should be preceding, there is no Ikara, Ikara, Ityadi letters preceding. So there, Savarna Dirgha of Ikara and Ikara or E and E is not an apavada to this sutra, but A plus A is an apavada to Guna by Savarna Dirgha Sandhi, Akas Savarna Dirgha, which will come up. Then there is another apavada to Guna as to when Akara, Akara are preceding and H is, sorry, and this part is H, A, O, I, AU. So when A, O, I or AU is immediately following Akara, Akara, then also Guna was ordained, but there will be an Apavada which will come up as to Vriddhi. So there Vriddhi will be ordained as to A, A plus H will result in Vriddhi. So an Apavada has been mentioned. So the example for Guna is what? Upendra. So Upendra is an example here. So Upa plus Indra. So this Upa Indra, Upa is ending with Akara, Avarna, and Indra is starting with Ach. So between A and Upa A and Indra E, there is a Guna Sandhi. So which should be the Adesha? Stane Antartamaha is used. So Ad Gunaha एक पूर्व प्रयोजि संहितायां गुण आदेश बट विच गुण लेटर शुड बी द रिप्लेसमेंट फॉर दैट स्थानांतरतमत्वम इज यूज्ड एंड द क्लोजेस्ट इन प्रॉक्सिमिटी विच इज व्हाट अ इज कंठ्या ई इज तालव्यः एंड देयर बाय बिटवीन अ एंड ई ए विच इज कंठ तालु सो कंठ अ इज कंठ्या एंड ई इज तालव्य देयरफॉर कंठ तालु एकार इज द रिप्लेसमेंट देयरफॉर यू गेट उप विल बिकम उप विल बिकम उपे by E, E also being replaced. So E and A here both are replaced by A. You will get Upa plus Indra is equal to Upendra. So you will get Upendra. Upendraha is the example. Then Ganga plus Udaka. Ganga plus Udaka, what will happen? Akara is Avarna and Ukara is Ach. Therefore, you will get by Sthane Antartamattam, you will get Okara Gangodakam. नेक्स्ट सूत्र इज अ संज्ञा सूत्र विच टेल्स यू द नेजलाइज्ड वोवेल इज अ इथ लेटर तस्य लोपः तस्य इतः लोपः उपदेशे जन्मनासिक इथ वी हैव सीन दिस मल्टीपल टाइम्स सो इथ व्हाट इज इथ उपदेशे इन एन उपदेश अच अनुनासिक अच इज एन इथ सो उपदेशे अनुनासिक अच इथ संज्ञक भवति विल टेक इथ संज्ञा एंड देयर बाय तस्य लोपः So nasalized vowel is an ith letter. We have seen this, so I'll skip this. The next sutra, which is also needed to mark this, when you have a guna. So when you have a guna, then you'll have an and. And in the place of ruvarna or ruvarna. So when and is a replacement for ru or lu, we have seen iko yanachi also. Iko yanachi, ik is replaced by yan. Now in this guna, what happens? In guna, when you have guna for ru or lu, you will have a as a replacement. When you have vruddhi for ru or lu, you will have a as a replacement. So these two will be replaced by and guna by guna letter or vriddhi. So thereby what happens is that you will get either a or a as a replacement for both ru and lu by guna or vriddhi respectively. Now what happens is this, if ru is replaced by a by guna, then you will get ar by urandrapara, and if it is by vruddhi, then you get R. Similarly, if lu is replaced, if lu is replaced by a as guna, then you will get al by urandraparaha and al by vruddhi after urandrapara. So ru guna is a plus urandrapara repa ar, and ru vruddhi is a, and then with urandrapara you will get R. Lu's guna is a, but you will get al after urandrapara, and lu gets the vruddhi a, and after urandrapara you will get al. So that is this urandraparaha sutra, which says uhu and raparaha bhavati whenever ru, since u shashti ekvachana of ru, so rukarasya, not rukarasya but ru, we have seen there is a ru and lu have mitasavarnam. So mitasavarna is there. So ru or lu, that is the meaning of, so shashti of this ru lukarayoho. So you can read it as both lukarayoho an adesha ra para bhavati. So an is ra para. So an adesha, as soon as it takes place, it will be ra para. So in the place of ruvarna and lavarna, you will get the an will be followed by rapara, means drepha or lakara will be paraha after that anadesha, akara or akara. So example is given Krishna ruddhi. So Krishna and ruddhi, between akara and rukara, here akara is an avarna, not this akara, sorry, this akara is a avarna, एंड दिस रू इज एन अच, देयर फोर गुणा इज ऑर्डेंड. सो आद गुणः ब्रिंग्स इन अकार एज द एक आदेश ऑफ पूर्व अकार एंड फॉलोइंग ऋकार. सो वेन बोथ ऑफ दीज आर रिप्लेस बाय अकार, रू विल हैव बीन रिप्लेस बाय अण. सो रू, ऑल्दो अकार एंड ऋकार बोथ आर रिप्लेस टुगेदर, स्टिल रू विल हैव बीन रिप्लेस. देयर फोर दिस वेन रू गेट्स एन आदेश ऑफ अण, अ इज अण अंतर्गत. Therefore, what will happen is that this Purandarapara will be invoked, and this Akara, which is part of An, will be Raparaha. And since Ru has a proximity of Sthanantartvattvam with Repha, Repha will be the Adesha of An being Raparaha. So, you will get Ar. So, you will get Krishna Riddhi will become Krishna Riddhi. Similarly, Tava Likaraha. If there is some kind of an association like that, sandhi like that, then you will get tava akara and this lukara is an ach. Tava akara is an avarna and then you have this lu as ach. So between them there is a guna sandhi. So a is a replacement for both of them together, and then this a being an an for this lukara also, which is uhu. Uhu means of the ru, and ru includes lu also. Therefore this lu being replaced by akara will invoke Purandarapara, and then by sthanantartamattvam lakara will be the raparattvam for an, which is this akara which is an. Then you will get tavalkaraha. So al, a is a guna replacement, and that a al guna an, that an will be raparaha. Therefore you will get al tavalkara. The other examples, rajarshaya, maharshi, so Saptarshi ityadi. Now Purvottara Siddham will be covered later, I think. Lokusha. So it will be covered in the next sutra. So you have a possibility of an optional sandhi lopa. So optional lopa of something, yakara vakara by lopa shakalyasya. So lopa shakalyasya is introduced here, and lopa shakalyasya is in the 8th chapter, third pada, 19th sutra. Therefore it is after 8.2.1. So whatever is after 8.2.1 is called as tripadi. Before this is called as sapara saptadhyayi. We have seen this. So sapada saptadhyayi sutras can apply out of sequence, but the tripadi antargata sutras cannot apply out of sequence. They will apply only in sequence. Meaning the earlier sutra, how is it known in Tripadi? The Purvottara Siddham, which will be covered later, will talk about this. So which says that the earlier sutra can see the earlier sutra cannot see the latter sutra's karya. The latter sutra can see the earlier sutra's karya. This is not only in the entire section of Tripadi, meaning 8.2.1 onwards, but any karya that takes place in Tripadi can also be not seen by the Sapada Saptadhyayi sutras. The Sapada Saptadhyayi karya can be seen by the Tripadi sutras, and within the Tripadi also there is a sequence of sutras in which only in that sequence the sutra should be applied, because otherwise the karya of the latter sutra cannot be seen by the earlier sutra. You cannot go back in application. So lopa shakalyasya is one such sutra, after which you cannot go and apply the earlier sutra. So shakalya is a vyakarana who preceded Panini Maharshi. So he says that lopaha shakalyasya, lopaha bhavati, kada bhavati, apurva and kasya bhavati. So apurvayo padantayo vyoho ashi samhitayam. So ashi pare, when ash antargata letters, meaning ach, ach plus hash. So ashi pare is ach plus hash. When ach and hash put together you get ash. So ashi, when ach or hash letter, one of these is following what? Following apurvayo padantayoho vyoho. So following vakara yakara, yakara or vakara, this ash is following, immediately following yakara or vakara, which yakara or vakara, that yakara or vakara which is apurva. Apurva means avarna purva. And this yakara or vakara should be at the end of the padanta, padanta yoho. So padanta yakara vakara preceded by an avarna and followed by an ash is subject to lopa. And since shakalya mata has been mentioned, therefore Panini Maharshi says that I am just quoting what he says, I am not saying it, meaning that what he says that lopa na bhavati, whereas Shakalya Muni says that lopaha bhavati. So Shakalya Vayakaran, Shakalya Acharya says that lopaha bhavati, therefore there is a vibhasha. So vibhasha va bhavati, lopo va bhavati. Thereby you will get two forms, yakara vakara may survive or yakara vakara may be dropped. So example is what? Hare iha pakshe. So yeah, so hare iha. So hare iha has been mentioned, hare, he hare, sambodhana, he hare, iha. So whatever iha, iha drishti bhavatu, so whatever you are praying to Hari and say hey hare iha. So there hare ekara and ikara. So between ekara and ikara, we have seen the sandhi hoyavayavaha. So h followed by ach will have a o I or av replacement. This ekara will be replaced by a o I or av. So ekara being part of h, ekara is the first one. So yatha sankhyam anudesha samanam will give you ay as the adesha. So you will get har ay. Ekar is replaced by ay. And then iha is still there. So haray iha. So you will get this form haray iha. This is a valid form. This is one form. Vibhashaya by vibhasha lopashakalyasya. So this is what va vibhasha. So if you apply this, then what will happen? This yakara, when will it be applicable? This yakara happens to be apurva. Apurva yakara, and hara is a pada, because hare is a pada, therefore this ekara being replaced by aye will not take away the pada, pada sanya of hare becoming harai. So harai is also a pada. So this yakara, which is a padanta yakara, which is apurva yakara, that yakara which is at the end of the pada preceded by avarna and followed by ikara which is an ach, which is an ash, sorry, not ach, ash. So ach is part of ach, ash anyway. So apurva padanta yakara which is followed by ash, and there is a samhita, sandhi between them. Therefore this lopa shakalyasya can take away yakara optionally. So when yakara goes away, you get hara iha. So you got hara iha as the second form. Now if akara and ikara can have guna sandhi, and thereby Ad gunaha can apply, you cannot apply, because Ad gunaha is which sutra? It is Ad gunaha, if you look at it. Just wanted to show you the number. So this 6187, 6th chapter, 6187. You cannot go in the Sapada Saptadhyayi again. Sapada Saptadhyayi. It occurs in Sapara Sapta. You cannot go from Lopa Shakalyasya to Adguna again or any sutra before the. In fact, you cannot go anywhere, even a single sutra behind from Tripadi, let alone chapters back. So you cannot go back and apply. So you cannot apply this Lopa Shakalyasya. After Lopa Shakalyasya, you cannot apply hara and iha becoming something else. Sorry, where did I go? For some reason I went, I pressed page down instead of page up. Sorry. So where are we? Eka purva parayoga sandhi. I don't know why it went so ahead, scrolled. सो यू कैनॉट गेट, यू कैनॉट गेट गुणा आफ्टर दिस. सो लोप शाकल्यस्य विल अप्लाई एंड टेक अवे अकार ऑप्शन, यू गेट हर इह. सो वन फॉर्म इज हर इह और अदर इज हर इह. सो पूर्वोत्तर सिद्धम इज मेंशन्ड, आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन व्हाट पूर्वोत्तर सिद्धम इज. सो 8-1 सूत्र सेज पूर्वोत्तर सिद्धम. सो हियर ऑनवर्ड्स दी वॉट एवर कार्य हैज टेकन प्लेस अर्लियर ओनली विल बी विजिबल टू दी लैटर एंड दी लैटर सूत्र कार्य कैनॉट बी सीन बाय दी अर्लियर. सो व्हाट डज इट से, पूर्व सूत्र दृष्ट्या न सिद्धम असिद्धम. सो पूर्व सूत्र दृष्ट्या इज द अर्थ ऑफ पूर्वोत्तर. सो पूर्वत्र उत्तरस्य सूत्रस्य कार्यम असिद्धं भवति. सो अर्लियर सूत्रा कैनॉट सी दी लैटर सूत्रस कार्य. सो एग्जांपल इज गिवन हियर, यू लुक एट नलोप प्रातिपदिकांतस्य. एनी वी हैव सीन वन एग्जांपल, यू कैनॉट गो बैक एंड अप्लाई दी हर इह, कैनॉट टेक एनी गुणा आफ्टर दिस. सो हियर sutra examples, in fact this sutra does not need examples, so I'll skip this. One is mentioning Vishna iha. So Vishna iha, we have seen Vishna iha, Vishno iha will become Vishna iha or Vishnu iha. So you cannot have sandhi between these two. So that was the explanation for why hara iha cannot have guna sandhi, which we have already studied in atsandhi earlier as to Aad Guna. Why it cannot be applied? Because Purvottara Siddham. That is the reason the Purvottara Siddham has been brought in. We don't need other examples there. All other examples are for the Vakara, Vishnu Iha. So that is an example for Yakara Vakara in Lopa Shakalyasya. And there also you cannot go back and do Guna Sandhi or any other Sandhi after Lopa Shakalyasya. The next Sutra is a Sanya Sutra, which is of Vriddhi Radeich. So Vriddhi Sanya is mentioned, which is the first Sutra in Ashtadhyayi, and it is considered as Vriddhi is the meaning of what? The Dhatu, Bruhi Vriddhau. So the Sutrakara did not do any Mangalacharana. So there is a question raised by Tikas as to why should Ashtadhyayi be studied, because it is not following Astika Sampradaya, wherein Mangalacharana should have been done, it is not done. So the Tika explains as to there is a Mangalacharana, there is no shloka you see in Mangalacharana, but in the sutras there is a Mangalacharana by the Vriddhi Shabda itself. So Vriddhi Shabda is the meaning of Bruhdhatu. Bruhdhatu is the dhatu which with Manin Pratyaya you get Brahma Shabda. Brahma is Parabrahma, Paramatma. So Paramatma, Atma, Parabrahma, Ishvara is covered, Mangalacharana is covered, Mangalacharana with the prayer to Ishvara is covered by this Vriddhi Shabda itself. Therefore, Vriddhi Radhaich Sutra itself is a Mangalacharana as well, and thereby it is definitely following the Astika Sampradaya, and thereby the Sutra should be studied. That is the answer given there. Anyway, it is a Sanya Sutra. So, Vriddhi At Aich. So, this At Vriddhi At Aich. So, At Aich has what? I. A O I out, so I and O. So Akara, Aikara and Aukara. Sorry, as I said, used to writing, so this is already given. So Dirga Akara, Dirga Aikara, Aukara get the Sanya as Vriddhi. And there again Taparakarana by Taparakarana, Taparha Yasmat will give you the Kala Niyama for Akara also and I and O as well. So at aicha vriddhi sanya syat. So sanya has been given. Now where does this vriddhi sanya find its application? In the vriddhi sandhi. So in the at sandhi there is a vidhi sutra vriddhi rechi. So vriddhi rechi says vriddhi hi echi. Echi means when an age follows, then there is a vriddhi ordained. Where does age follow? Age follows avarna. So avarna immediately followed by age, both आत एक पूर्व परयो संहितायाम देर इज अनुवृत्ति. सो आत मीनिंग आफ्टर एन अवर्ण, आफ्टर एन अवर्ण वेन एन एच एच ई एच इज फॉलोइंग देन वृद्धि इज एन आदेश फॉर पूर्व परयो हो एक आदेश संहितायाम विषय. सो देर इज अ सिंगल आदेश फॉर बोथ अवर्ण एंड एच. वॉट इज एग्जाम्पल, example, if you look at it, Krishna and Ekatva. So Krishna, Ekatva, He Krishna, Ekatva, something like that is there, then what will happen is Ekatvam. So Ekatvam will be the Shabda there. So Ekara followed, Ekara following Avarna. So Avarna is preceding Ekara, H is following. What will happen there? Both will be replaced by Aikara as a Vriddhi letter, Vriddhihi, H-E, H-E pare, after when an H follows Avarna, I is the Adesha here, Vriddhi, I is the, by Sthane Antartamattu, Kanta Thalu. So A is Kanthya and A is Talavya, so Kanta Thalu is Aikara, therefore Aikara is the Adesha, not Akara or Aukara. So you will get Krishnai, Krishnaikatvam. So Krishnaikatvam, Ganga Ugaha, so Ganga Akara and Og. Og, so this, what is following is this Og. So H is following, H can be Ekara, Okara, Aikara or Aukara. So any of these four, when they are following, then you will get a Vriddhi replacement for both preceding and following. Similarly here, Aukara is Adesha, Daivaishwaryam, so Deva, Aishwaryam, I is following, again I is the, Vriddhi is the Adesha, it will be Aikara only. And then again, Krishna, Autkanthyam, so there also, Aukara is the Adesha, which is the Vriddhi. So these are the examples for, which is what, Purvapara Eka, Eka Rupa Sandhi. The next sutra is a Vidhi Sutra, which brings in Vriddhi as an Adesha in a certain scenario. So this, I'll just quickly go through this as to what is there in the, covered in the sutra. It is a very specific application. Some dhatus are mentioned or some Adesha which should be following Avarna. So Avarna precedes and something else follows, H follows, but then there is some expectation, but Vriddhi should take place there. So therefore there is a sutra here as to gives a, as I said, Vidhi Sutra gives a variation of the Vriddhi Sandhi rule. There is a variation of this Vriddhi. Etyedat yutshu. So at puro parayo ekah Vriddhi eche sanyatayam. So the scenario is similar, but specific conditions are given. What is specific condition? Avarna. In all these three conditions are mentioned. Avarna is preceding. What should be following? H should be following. This H should be a part of Ind dhatu. So eti, eti edhati utsu, eti edhati utsu. So saptami bahuvachana, therefore eti, H should be following, eti, eti should be the form following, edhati should be the form following or utsu. So what is that form? Ind dhatu form. So ind dhatu rupa, which gives ekara in the as the beginning letter, or edhati. Edhati is also beginning with Ekara, which is part of H. And Oot is an Adesha ordained for something, that Oot Ukara should be following. Then also this Vriddhi will be Eka Adesha for Purva and Para. So example is given there as to, so what is Eti? Eti is by Ikstipau Dhatur Nirdeshe. Ik and Stip are used as Pratyas for the dhatus, whereby dhatu, whatever form you get, that stands for a dhatu. How do you talk about a dhatu? Only a pada can be talked about. You cannot take a dhatu and talk about dhatu itself. You cannot say bhu, and you cannot use bhu in a vakya. But when you want to talk about bhu dhatu, then you have to say bhavati. Bhavati is not tinganta there, subanta. How? By ikstipau dhatu nirdeshe. So in dhatu plus tip has been added, so stip is shit pratya, it will give a sarvadhatu sanya ityadi, and the form will be eti. So eti stands for ind gatu gatau dhatu, ind dhatu in the gati artha, gati artha ka ind dhatu. That dhatu, how do you identify ind dhatu? How do you use the pada ind dhatu? So you say eti. So eti is a pratipadika which stands for ind dhatu. It is not a tinganta form. Eti is a subanta which stands for ind dhatu itself. Similarly, edhati for edhavruddho, etc. So, example is here. So, upa plus eti. So upa plus eti, upa is ending with avarna, so there is an avarna, and then eti is beginning with a, and this eti is in gatau dhatu form itself eti. In the form itself is eti. So upa plus upa pura upa is a upasarga. So upasarga upa ends with avarna and eti in gatau dhatu form begins with h. So you have h following avarna, and here adguna is prapta, which is negated by what? Vriddhirechi. Now this vriddhirechi was already an apavada for adguna, because adguna has anuvritti of achi pare. So h is also part of h is a part of ach as well. Therefore achi pare gunaha bhavati at after an akara, that was negated by vriddhirechi. So you had an apavada. So vriddhirechi, vriddhi is applicable. Then why do you need this sutra? Because there is another sutra. Vriddhirechi is followed by, vriddhirechi is 6188, which is immediately after 6187 ad guna. So guna is negated by vriddhi in this case. We did not need vriddhi to be ordained again by edhati utsu sutra, but it is needed because 6194 has replaced this vriddhi adesha by engi pararupam. Pararupam, so pararupam would have given you ekara as the adesha, meaning akara and ekara both would have been replaced by pararupa, meaning ekara, by engi pararupam, because eng, h is part of eng. So when eng follows, then pararupa ekara would have been adesha, which is not the form that we need. Therefore that pararupa adesha is replaced by purva parayo ekadesha, which is not pararupa but which is vriddhi, by eti edat yutsu. So this sutra brings back vriddhi instead of pararupa ekara, which is, happens to be a guna letter. So guna would have taken place by adguna, then vriddhi would have taken place by vriddhirechi as an apavada to adguna, but engi pararupa was a pararupam was an apavada to vriddhi also, and it brought back ekara, which is following as a single adesha, which is not needed here. We want this vriddhi. Therefore etyedhat yutsu brings back another apavada. By another apavada it brings back vriddhi letter, which is aikara. Therefore by etyedhat yutsu you would get upaiti, not upeti but upaiti. This is the form that we need. Similarly edhati also you'll get upaidhate, and then oot adesha, the example is vah prapane dhatu followed by nui. So what happens here is that vaha, this nakara will cause ata upadhaya vriddhihi, and then you'll get vah from this. So the prashta purvaka vaha, so you'll get prashta vaha, and then shas declination is shown in subanta. What happens here, what you expect the form to be, here you will get. So there's too many steps there. So oot is this oot, vaha oot. So vaha will be replaced by oot. Oot is an adesha. This oot, when you have oot, there is an prashta a. Prashta has a ending with a varna followed by oot. So this would have given what? A plus oo. A plus oo, you would have expected ad guna, which is prapta. Ad guna, guna is prapta, but you don't want guna here. You want vriddhi by etadyet. Eti edhati utsu, etadyet utsu, you will get vriddhi, and there you will get aukara. So akara, ukara is not guna here. You will get aukara, prashto. That is the example here. There are some vartikas here. I am going to skip through these vartikas. As it is, there is a specific application. Under them there is vartika, which is more specific. We have covered all this. Those who are interested can look up the recordings. So there are some very specific vartikas. I'll skip these. The next sanya sutra introduced is उपसर्ग क्रियायोगे प्रादयः. सो प्रादयः इज द अर्लियर सूत्र. यू गेट अनुवृत्ति ऑफ प्रादय फ्रॉम द अर्लियर सूत्र. सो उपसर्गः इज द संज्ञा इंट्रोड्यूस. व्हेन यू गेट उपसर्ग एज द संज्ञा, जनरली वी से उपसर्ग इज अ प्रीफिक्स, बट उपसर्ग इज पारिभाषिक. उपसर्ग हैज अ मीनिंग. इट इज नॉट एनी प्रीफिक्स, इट इज दैट प्रीफिक्स विच हैज क्रियायोग. ओनली देन इट कैन बी कॉल्ड एज उपसर्ग. सो वेन देर इज अ क्रियायोग, क्रियायोग क्रियया योग क्रियायोग क्रियाया क्रियया सह योग. ओनली वेन देर इज योग विथ क्रिया. विच क्रिया? क्रिया ऑफ दी धातु, इंडिकेटेड बाय दी धातु इन दी पदा दैट फॉलोज. वेन दी पदा फॉलोज, दैट पदा विल हैव अ पर्टिकुलर धातु. दैट धातु इंडिकेट सम क्रिया. विथ दैट क्रिया इफ दी प्रादि, प्र आदि, प्रादि इज अ प्रादि गण. देर आर सम 22 प्रादि, दे आर कंसिडर्ड पदाज ऑल्सो. सो शब्दास, देर आर प्र आदि शब्दास स्टार्टिंग विथ प्र. सो प्र इत्यादि शब्दास आर देर, दे आर प्रादि. सो प्रादि गण है सम 22 एंटिटीज. वेन दिस 22, वन ऑफ दी 22 शब्दास प्रिसीड सम पदा विच हैज अ धातु, दैट धातु इंडिकेट सम क्रिया. इफ दिस प्र इत्यादि हैज क्रिया योग, मीनिंग अन्वया, क्रिया अन्वया विद दी धातु क्रिया इन दी नेक्स्ट पदा, देन अलोन दिस प्र आदि प्रादि कैन बी कॉल्ड एज उपसर्ग. अदरवाइज इट विल रिटेन, इट विल जस्ट बी अ प्रादि, प्लेन प्रादि. सो यू विल सी, एस्पेशली यू विल सी इन प्रादि बहुरी, वेन यू सी बहुरी यू विल सी वॉट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रादि बहुरी. समटाइम्स यू विल बी तत्पुरुष ऑल्सो, बट यू हैव टू सी एज टू वेदर देर इज अ क्रिया योग, इज इट उपसर्ग और नॉट. सो उपसर्ग इज दी संज्ञा गिवन टू दिस प्रादि ओनली वेन देर इज क्रिया योग विद दी धातु दैट फॉलोज इन द पदा. सो दिस 22 पार्टिकल्स आर द पार्ट ऑफ प्रादि. विच आर दोज? सो दोज आर डिस्कस्ड, लिस्टेड हियर, प्र परा अप सम इत्यादि. सो यू कैन गो थ्रू दिस लिस्ट एज टू देर आर 22, एंड देन देर कैन बी कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दीज ऑल्सो. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल उपनिषद. सो उपनिषद हैज ऑल ऑफ, देर आर देर टू. सो उप एंड देर इज अ निर ऑल्सो एंड निस ऑल्सो. सो शदल धातु एंड उप. सो उप प्लस निषद, दिस निर निस और निर, सम कंसिडर दीज एज टू एंड सम कंसिडर दिस दुस एंड दुर एज टू डिफरेंट. दे कैन बी कंसिडर एज वन ऑल्सो. सो सम कंसिडर दैम एज वन, बट एनी वे इट इज लिस्टेड डिफरेंटली. विल सी निस एंड निर डिफरेंटली, दुस एंड दुर डिफरेंटली. बट इन संधि वॉट हैपन्स इज रे प सकार विसर्ग, दे आर ऑफ द सेम फॉर्म्स, forms of the same letter, meaning sakara will become ru and ru will become visarga. So sakara, repha and visarga can be out of either dus or dur. So sakara dus antargata sakara or dur antargata repha. Similarly nis or nir also, in the sandhi they will become repha anyway, ru. Therefore some consider them as one. So they have many meanings anyway. Avyaya kosha will talk about a lot of meanings for these. And it gets very technical as to, you know, what meaning should be taken. So this is all learnt only in the Sampradaya, in the Bhashya, Tika, Ityadi, for a particular Shabda which is being interpreted. So Ete Pradaya, these are the Pradayas. Lagu introduces all these. So Upapurvaka, Nipurvaka, Shadril Dhatu will give you Upanishad. So there are combinations also. You can have one, two, multiple, more than two of these coming in combination and becoming Upasargas or remaining Pradi. See, it is mentioned meaning wise there is no difference between nis and nir and dus and dur. So now these are needed when you have kriya yoga with what? With the dhatu. Then what is this dhatu? Dhatu has to be introduced. So dhatu sanya is introduced next in this sanya sutra. Bhu adayo dhatavaha. So bhu vadayaha dhatavaha. So you have these धातवः, धातु इज संज्ञा गिवन, धातवः भू वा आदयः आदि, बिगिनिंग भू वा, यू विल गेट व्हाट? धातु संज्ञा, दे आर धातु, कॉल्ड एज धातु. सो क्रियावाचिनः भादयः धातु संज्ञा स्यु. क्रियावाचिनः, दीज आर ऑल इंडिकेटिव ऑफ क्रिया, सम एक्शन. सो वर्ब इज बेसिकली डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम अ धातु. सो इज सुबंता इन संस्कृत, बट जनरली यू सी तिंगंत शब्दास कमिंग फ्रॉम अ धातु डायरेक्टली. सो विच धातु इज देर? यू लुक फॉर अ धातु देर. So that dhatu is kriyavach shabda. It stands for an action. So examples are bhusattayam. So this kriyavachi, why kriyavachi? Because sattvavachi here, bhu, prithvi is also there. Prithvi is the meaning of bhu. But that bhu is not meant here. Here sattayam meaning bhu. Sattayam is a kriya. So then sattayam, satta is a kriya. So sattarupa kriyavachi bhu is a dhatu. Whereas prithvivachi, sattvavachi bhu is not a dhatu. So it is subantapada, you get bhu. Bhu is also the meaning of, so bhumi, where you get bhu is bhumi, prithvi. That is not a dhatu. Then va. Va is also mentioned to clarify this as to va gati gandhanayoho. Well, va is what? Vibhasha vikalpa va or. So this va or, which stand, means or, vikalpa, vibhasha. Lopa shakalya se va syat. So shakalya perspective is that there should be a lopa. So there is a vibhasha va, that or. That is not a dhatu. Va is not a dhatu. But this va is a dhatu. So kriyavachi va is dhatu, vikalpavachi va is not a dhatu. Therefore bhu vadayaha. So there bhu and va are both are included, so that you can, so bhu satta meaning only should be taken, and va gati gandhanayoho meaning alone should be taken, meaning only that bhu and va should be picked and given the sanya as dhatu. Therefore two dhatus have been included, where in that listing, in the bhu adi, in that listing where bhu and va both are listed, that kind of a series alone will get the entities, in that kind of a series alone will get the dhatu sanya, which are kriyavachi. Whereas this bhu prithvi is not listed in together with va vikalpa. Therefore this bhu and va listing together, this va will not be there, only this va will be there. Therefore gati gandhanayoho kriyavachi va will be called as dhatu. So this va will restrict this bhu from becoming this bhu, and this bhu sattayam will restrict this va gati gandhanayo alone to take the dhatu sanya, not va vikalpa. So therefore bhu adaya, because there is a question as, so it is not vadaya, vadi is a gana, but bhu vadaya is, in the sutra there are two dhatus listed which will get dhatu sanya. There is another dhatu sanya sutra also, which is a derived dhatu. So there will be sanadyantaha dhatavaha. That sutra will come up when sun comes up, when lahu needs that sanadi pratya, that time he'll bring in. So that is not listed here right now. The next sutra is upasargad ruti dhatu. So what happens here? Upasarga is needed. Upasarga has already been defined earlier. So that upasarga and dhatu, which are two defined now in the sutra, upasarga, upasarga, the upasarga sanya has been used, and dhatu, in that dhatu sanya has been used. So upasarga dhruti dhatu at purvaparayoho ekaha vriddhi samhitayam. So in the sandhi sutra he needed this upasarga as well as dhatu sanya. Therefore those two have been introduced, sanya sutras. Now vidhi sutra is a sandhi sutra. What is that? Vriddhi. Vriddhi eka is the adesh, ekaha purvaparayoho at, after an avarna. Which avarna? That avarna which is upasargat, meaning after an upasarga. So after an upasarga, when you have an avarna, then what is following? So this ru, here this dhatu is following. So dhatu, when dhatu follows. So upasargad ruti. Ruti says what? Ruti is saptami ekvachana. So here, so upasargad is panchami. So upasarga should be preceding. What should be following? Ruti. Rut should be rukara. Taparakarana is there. So rut should be, rukara should be following, immediately following. And what kind of a this upasargat avarnat at is there? So upasarga, and this is upasarga, is what is preceding. This is also at. So upasargad at, preceding. What is following? Ruti dhatu. What is following is ruti dhatu. So rukara of a dhatu should be following. So I am saying P and F. So P is what is preceding. So upasargad at preceding, ruti dhatu following. Then purva parayo ekaha vriddhihi adesha. So ekaha vriddhihi is the adesha. So So what is preceding and what is following? If you look at it, upasarga avarna and then riti dhatu, rukara of the dhatu. Dhatu has been defined, upasarga has been defined. You already know what is avarna and rut. Then vritti is a replacement. This has also been introduced. So now this sutra is easily understood with an example now. So the example is this pradi gana pra, which should have kriya yoga with the dhatu here, rut dhatu. So ruchati. So ruchati is the form. So you have ru following avarna. This avarna is upasargat. It is part of the upasarga, meaning upasarga is preceding. Because it has the, in the vivaksha, this pradi pra. So prakarshena ruchati, some kind of a meaning would be there as to kriya yoga. Prakarshena ruchati. So then prapurvaka ruchati. Rudhatu is a prapurvaka ruchati. So here ruchdhatu is in sixth gana, parasmipadi dhatu. So pra is an upasarga. Why? Prakarshena ruchati is the vivaksha. So then pra plus ruchati, what should be the sandhi there? So upasarga dhruti dhatu vriddhi will take place. Between pra and ru, pra akara and rukara, a and ru, there will be sandhi which is vriddhi. And then urandrapara will bring a repha for the adesha, which is what? So sandhi between a and ru being vriddhi, vriddhi is akara. Akara's vriddhi is also akara, rukara's vriddhi is also akara. So both akara and rukara will be replaced by single akara. That akara is an un, therefore it will invoke urandrapara and then it will become r and then you get prarchati. So form will be prarchati. That is the example for upasarga dhruti dhatu vriddhi. So there is a technical question raised as to here. If upasargad is there, then why dhatu is mentioned? Because dhatu will always be there in the following word. So the answer is in prakriti bhava. There prakriti bhava will see by rutyakaha. So when prakriti bhava is again another technicality which is ordained in a vidhi. Then the next vidhi sutra, sandhi sutra, is what? Engi pararupam. At upasargat dhatu puro parayoho ekaha samhitayam. So when there is samhita, there is a ekadesha for the preceding and following. But what? Again upasargat dhatu. But then engi puro rupam, engi pararupam. And this is the sutra because of which there would have been a pararupa sandhi. And an apavada to this we have already seen as what? Etye dhati utsu. So that was an apavada to this sutra. This sutra is an apavada to vriddhi. Which vriddhi? Vriddhi rechi. So vriddhi rechi, which is an apavada to adgunaha, has an apavada in engi pararupam. So this brings in eng when it is following, although it is part of h, it will be a single adesha, as in eng itself will be an adesha for purva and para as pararupa. Pararupa means only para is the following. So the following form is the adesha, pararupa. Eng is following, so eng itself will be the adesha. Pararupa is what? Eng. Whatever is the eng letter, that itself is the adesha for avarna and eng both put together. Which avarna? That avarna which is part of an upasarga. So it is an upasarga following, preceding. Preceding is an upasarga, and that upasarga is what? Avarna ending. Because upasargad at, that means upasarga should be preceding. And what is preceding? That is an avarna as well. So avarna which is part of an upasarga, part meaning what? That avarna will be the ending letter. Then alone the ang which is following will itself be a replacement for both the preceding and following, when that ang is part of the dhatu. And which part? Obviously it should be the initial letter. Thereby both of avarna and ang, avarna of the upasarga when preceding ang of the dhatu, will take ang adesha. Both avarna and ang will take ang adesha. Pararupa. So example is what? Pra purvaka ejate. So ejru deeptau dhatu is there in the meaning of shining, to shine. So ejru upadesha janunasika it, thereby age will be the content age. So ejate will be the form when you derive it, tinganta form. थर्ड पर्सन सिंग्युलर. सो ए जते प्र पूर्वक ए जते. नाउ दिस प्र इज एन उपसर्ग वाय प्रकर्षेण ए जते. यू हैव क्रियायोग देन प्र अकार एंड एज एंग विच इज ऑल्सो एन एज विच इज ऑल्सो एन अच. फर्स्ट इट इज एन अच. दिस अ इज अवर्ण. दिस अवर्ण विच इज फॉलोड बाय एकार विच इज एन अच विल ब्रिंग इन आद गुण. अपवाद टू दैट इज एकार इज पार्ट ऑफ एच देर फोर वृद्धि रेची विल ब्रिंग इन वृद्धि एज एन आदेश. नाउ दिस अच विच इज एन एच विच इज ऑल्सो एन एंग विल बी एन अपवाद बाय एंगी पर रूपम एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ आद गुण गुण विल नॉट बी दी आदेश. वृद्धि विल नॉट बी दी आदेश बट पर रूप विल बी दी आदेश विच पर रूप पर रूप इज एंग इट सेल्फ. सो देर फोर प्र अकार एंड एकार बोथ आर रिप्लेस्ड बाय अ सिंगल एकार विच इज द सेम एकार एज दिस एकार एंड देर फोर यूल गेट एंग आदेश. सो प्र प्लस एजते विल बिकम प्रेजते. यू विल गेट प्रेजते इज द फॉर्म नॉट वृद्धि नॉट गुण बट प्रेजते. सिमिलरली उप ओषति विल गिव यू उपोषति पर रूप संधि. I'll skip the Vartika. There is a Sanya Sutra Achontyadi T. Achontyadi T. So T is a Sanya introduced. So somewhere in the application area is what Ter Lopaha. So T will undergo Lopa. So Ter Lopaha or T will be replaced by something Tere. So Atmanepadanam Tere. So Tehe A. So T will take A Adesha. Tere or Ter Lopaha. Tehe Lopaha is the another sutra. These are all what? The application area for the T Sanya. So T is needed. This T is defined as what? Achaha Antyadi. Achaha Antyadi T. What does this mean? So Antya Adi T. So T is a Sanya given for Achaha. For that antya ach. Antya ach adi meaning that which has the last ach in its beginning. So if there is a hal, there is a first ach, there is another hal, there is a second ach. So this second ach will become antya ach, last ach. This ach, first ach is not antya ach, but this second ach is antya ach because that is the last ach, there is no third ach. Therefore this second ach will become Antya Ach and that Antya Achah Adi. Adi Yasya. Yasya Akshara Samuasya. Therefore, this entire thing starting with this Antya Ach as the Adi, the first one, whatever goes on till the end of the set of letters. So, whatever is the segment, this entire thing, this will be called as T. This will get the T Sanya. Meaning what? Basically, whatever begins with the last vowel, those set of letters will be called as T. So acham madhye yaha antyaha saha adi yasya tat ti sanyam sya yasya akshara samuhasya. That akshara samuha which has last ach at its beginning, that will be called as T. So for example here, so what is the T here? A will be the T. What is the T in atam? Am will be the T. In jh a again, in atham am, in dhvam am, in e itself, in vahi ikara, in mahi ikara. So that is how you find out T. So you can look at the your names also and see what is the T as an exercise. Then there is a vartika. I'll skip the vartika. So it is needed here. You look at omangoscha at ek of puro parayoho pararupam samhitayam. So ओमांगोश्च पररूप संधि इज अ विधि सूत्र. सो इन द संधि सूत्र व्हाट आई सेड ओम आंग ओश्च ओमांगोश्च इज सप्तमी द्विवचन. सो व्हेन ओम और आंग आर फॉलोइंग फॉलोइंग व्हाट अवर्ण आत इज देयर देयरफॉर अवर्ण शुड बी प्रीसीडिंग देन व्हाट इज द संधि बिटवीन दीज टू. द संधि इज पररूप मीनिंग दिस ओम ओकार आंग आकार will be the replacement for both avarna and okara or avarna and akara. So this is an apavada sutra as well. So example given is shivaya om. So Shivaya Om. What is Sandhi? What do you expect? Ya is Akara. So Ad Gunaha. O is Ach. So this Guna, Ad Gunaha, Guna is Prapta. But it is not applied. Then why? Because Vriddhirechi. O is also part of H. Therefore Vriddhirechi, Vriddhi is Prapta. So this is also negated. By what? This Sutra. Om Angosha. You need Pararupa. So Guna is replaced by Vriddhi, is negated by Vriddhi, and Vriddhi is negated by Pararupa Sandhi. So Pararupa will apply and you will get Shivaya Om, Shivayom. Shivaya Om will be Shivayom. There will be no Guna or Vriddhi, you will get Shivayom. So here if you look at it, the T has not been used here. Just thinking where is so here you the I think in some Vartika it has been used, so I skipped that, so we didn't see the application of T there, but it will be used in Ter Lopa Ityadi or Tehe Ityadi. We'll stop here, we'll continue in the next sutra. There's an Atidesha sutra, we'll see in the next part. Ratavasane Nataraja Rajo Nana Dadakkanopamchavaram उद्धर्तु कामस सनकादि सिद्धाने तद्विमर्शे शिवसूत्रजालम. नमस्ते, धन्यवाद. आई विल सी यू इन नेक्स्ट पार्ट.
धन्यवाद.